Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. First things first, next week's video will be the monthly Q&A. Please post your questions in the comment section or in the Ask Daoyi channel of the Daoyi Discord, or email me if you prefer to remain anonymous. I will do my best to answer them for you. I really enjoy doing Q&A videos, and I think it helps all of us get better informed. In today's video, I will introduce Chan Si Jin or Silk Reeling Energy. I have talked about the Chan Si Jin in a couple of prior videos already. For example, I introduced two categories of Silk Reeling Energy, Shun Chan and Ni Chan, in response to a request from a community member, Mr. William Pamistery. Another community member missed the offer. Jill Cohen, sorry if I'm butchering your name, asked some detailed questions about Silk Reeling Energy, such as the illustration of Silk Reeling Energy in Chen Xin's book, for which I had promised a dedicated video. Today is the day I fulfill that promise. Ms. Cohen, I know it is a bit late than expected, so thank you for your patience. Topics covered in today's video include: first, Chen Xin; second, origin and meaning of Silk Reeling; third, types of Silk Reeling; fourth, the practice of Silk Reeling; fifth, misperceptions of Silk Reeling; sixth, demonstration; and seventh, takeaway. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Topic 1. Chen Xin. Before starting, I'd like to remind you that I have briefly introduced Chen Xin in one of the Tai Chi introduction videos. However, I'd like to reintroduce him here so that you all get a quick idea. Chen Xin, the 8th generation of Chen style Tai Chi, who lived from 1849 to 1929, was one of the most important Tai Chi masters in history. He was the author of the most important Chen style Tai Chi book, the Chen Shi Tai Chi Quan Tu Shuo, or Illustration of Chen Style Tai Chi. He started writing his book in 1908 and completed it in 1919. So, in total, he spent 12 years completing this great Tai Chi work. His book is considered a milestone in Tai Chi theory and, in my opinion, any serious Tai Chi practitioner in China must read it. I always say that there is no secret in Tai Chi. However, if there are any, then you can find all of them in this book. This is how I describe and praise this book. I believe that Chen Xin's Tai Chi book is a timeless classic and will be relevant as so long as people practice Tai Chi. Well, there have been practitioners like Wu Yuxiang and some others that made impactful literary contributions. No other book comes close to Chen Xin's book in terms of the breadth and depth of knowledge. By the way, this book is not for Tai Chi beginners. In other words, this book is for those who want to understand the Tai Chi theory on a much deeper level after mastering Tai Chi practice. So, what kind of Tai Chi did Chen Xin practice? Was his Tai Chi the same as one of the popular styles of Tai Chi? The answer is, Chen Xin practiced Chen Shi Xiao Jia, or small frame Chen style Tai Chi, which is different from Da Jia, or big frame Chen style Tai Chi taught by Chen Fa Ke branch. After Chen Fa Ke moved to Beijing from the Chen village, the big frame became the dominant style due to its popularity. Still, 小价 is still popular in many areas of China, including Chen Village, Xi'an, and others. Furthermore, I'd like to point out that the original Chen style practice created by Chen Wangting, the founder of Chen style Tai Chi, was the same as 小价. The big frame or 大价was a much later creation by Chen Youben and Chen Changxing, less than 200 years ago. Both Chen Youben and Chen Changxing were the sixth generations of Chen style Tai Chi. Also, Yang Lu Chan, the founder of Yang style Tai Chi, actually learned the 小架 or small frame. So,The old Yang style should be very close to small frame Chen style Tai Chi. Chen Xin reorganized the small frame from the prior 70 forms to 64 forms in his book by drawing inspiration from the 64 hexagrams to imply a relationship between the Yi Jing and the Tai Chi practice.Giving Chen Xin's massive importance in Chen style Tai Chi history, many people a few decades ago began to call his form Chen Xin Quan Jia, or Chen Xin Martial Frame, or simply Chen Xin Frame. So, Chen Xin was memorialized by prepending his name to an existing style. Before I can introduce Chen Xin Frame,I have to introduce Mr. Shi Lei, an important, though not a well-known name. His contribution in promoting Chen Xin's practice is outstanding. Mr. Shi was a disciple of Chen Kedi, and Chen Kedi studied directly under Chen Xin. Shi Lei wrote a book titled Chen Xin Quan Jia,or Chen Xin Martial Frame. This book has not been publicly published and has only been circulated among a small group of practitioners in the community. In order to understand the Chen style small frame, I visited him many years ago. This is the book he gave me. So far,I have shared this book only with some of my close friends and students, since this book is the only book in China that introduces Chen Xin's Tai Chi practice with a detailed explanation. I do not practice the small frame Chen style, but Chen Xin's book and Shi Lei's explanation do a great job in helping the reader understand Tai Chi concepts.And are a must read, no matter what style of Tai Chi you practice. Unfortunately, Mr. Shi passed away on the 4th of March 2022, just 8 days before the release of this video, at age 98. He was a great Tai Chi practitioner and a gem of a person. Though relatively not so well knownI consider him a very important figure in Tai Chi, and his passing was a great loss to me and I feel also to the Tai Chi community. I give credit to Mr. Shi Lei for improving my understanding of Chen Xin's concept. I will really miss his presence, but to me, he will continue to live on through his teachings. To summarize, Chen Xin,An outstanding Tai Chi practitioner wrote the book Illustration of Chen Style Tai Chi. His book is a must read for any serious Tai Chi practitioners looking to advance their understanding of Tai Chi concepts. Second, origin and meaning of Silk Reeling. The term Chan Si Jin consists of three characters. Chan means reeling.Si means silk, Jin means energy or power. put together, it means silk reeling energy. Chen Xin created this term and first used in his book. It is one of the many examples of Chen Xin's original contributions to Tai Chi theory. Even though Chen Xin was the first to use the term silk reeling energy, similar terms were used before his time. For example, Chen Wangting, the founder of Chen style Tai Chi, wrote a Tai Chi poem. The first sentences of the poem is, Zong Fang Qi Shen Ren Mo Zhi, Zhu Kao Chan Rao Wo Yi Jie Yi. Here, he used the term Chan Rao, or twisting, to describe the characteristics of a Tai Chi movement. Chan Rao, or twisting, is a two-dimensional movement, while silk reeling is a three-dimensional in a subtle way in executing this action. This is why Chan Sijin, or silk reeling energy, is a much more precise term describing the nature of a Tai Chi movements. Chen Xin said in his book, quote, Tai Chi Quan, Chan Fa Ye, end quote. Translation, Tai Chi is the practice of silk reeling. He also said, quote, Da Tai Chi Quan, Xu Ming Chan Si Jing, Chan Si Zhe, Yun Zhong Qi Zhi Fan Men Ye, Bu Ming Si Ji, Bu Ming Quan, end quote. Translation, to practice Tai Chi, you must understand silk reeling energy. Silk reeling is the method to circulate your internal energy. You will not be able to understand Tai Chi martial art without understanding silk reeling energy. End translation. That should give you an idea of the importance of silk reeling energy in Tai Chi practice. Also, worth noting is that in Chen Xin's book, he used the term Chan Si Jin sometimes, while some other times he used Chan Si Jing. Even though Jin and Jing are two different characters with subtle differences, they are interchangeable in this context. In Taoist literature, Jing or essence is the foundation of energy, and energy is the function of essence. For the sake of comprehension, I will use the term Chan Si Jin, or silk reeling energy instead of silk reeling essence for the rest of this video. I'd like to point out that Ba Ji Quan, a famous Chinese martial art style, uses a similar term Chan Jin to describe a technique. Chan means reeling, Jin means energy. Chan Jin means reeling energy or winding energy. Actually, it is more about a technique rather than the type of energy like used in Chen style Tai Chi. Furthermore, Chan Jin or winding energy or winding technique is a common martial technique in many Chinese martial art styles. In many Chinese martial styles, but Chan Si Jin or silk reeling energy is a very unique type of energy in Chen style Tai Chi practice. Now, let's look at the famous silk reeling energy attribution, which is what Mr. Cohen asked me about in his message. Actually, there are two attributions in total, one each for the front and the back side of the body. Chen Xin called them Ren Ti Chan Si Tu, body silk reeling attribution. According to Chen Xin, the whole body should have silk reeling energy, and all of the silk reeling energy should be circulated with movement. He also emphasized that all of the energy should be managed by the mind, moving inward to the bones and the joint, and moving outward to the skin. There's only a single stream of silk reeling energy every time instead of multiple streams. He also mentioned the coordination between each part of the body in order to apply the energy effectively. Bear in mind that even though these two illustrations show multiple streams of energy flows, in martial practice, there is only one stream that unifies all others at any time. I cannot emphasize this enough. To summarize, Chen Xin created the term circulating energy based on Chen Wangting's Tai Chi poem. Circulating energy is considered the most important fundamental practice of Chen style Tai Chi. So, how many types of circulating practice exist? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 3. Type of circulating. According to Chen Xin's book, there are 12 types of circulating energy organized in 6 pairs. Those are, I quote, 进禅、退禅、左右禅、上下禅、里外禅、大小禅、顺逆禅, end quote. Translation, forward and backward, left and right, upward and downward, inward and outward, big and small, 顺 and 逆. This list can be overwhelming, especially to beginners, because it is not a good solution to categorize these different types of circulating energy. If we analyze those movements, we can recognize them based on two criteria. First, 顺禅 or 逆禅, and second, expanding or contracting movements. With this, we will be able to clearly understand the nature of Chan Si Jin. Now, let's talk about these two criteria one by one. For the first criterion, we have to first know what 顺禅 and 逆禅 are. I have a video talking about this topic. Now, let me replay that part. Now, my second question is, how did Chen Xin define and describe this term? Let's look into his book. In his book, Chen Xin defined and explained 顺禅 and 逆禅, or positive and negative circulating in many places. Let me show you what he said. Quote, 胳膊尽由心发，行于肩，过肘至指，此是顺禅法。由骨至皮肤，由肩至指出进也。由指至肩，道禅法。所谓入经者，引之而来，使敌近于我者。Translation: The energy of the arm is initiated by the mind. It then transferred to the shoulder, elbow, and fingers. This is the 顺禅. The energy transfer is from bones to skin, an outward direction of energy. The 逆禅 is the energy moving from fingers to shoulder, an inward direction of energy in order to lead the energy inward and the opponent moving close to our body. This is the explanation provided by Chen Xin, the creator of the term 顺逆. Now, what makes this very clear that 顺禅 or positive circulating, clockwise circulating, is the energy movement during outward movement. 逆禅 or negative circulating or counterclockwise circulating is energy movement during inward movement. Of course, to practice the correct inward and outward movement, you have to use the right body part to lead the movement. For example, if your hand is working on 逆禅 or inward movement, then your little finger should lead the circulating energy. This is the definition of 顺禅 and 逆禅 written in Chen Xin's book. Chen Xin used the direction of energy as a standard to distinguish between 顺禅 and 逆禅. This is the original source of this term. Chen Zhaokui, the son of Chen Fa Ke, created another method to distinguish between Shun Chan and Ni Chan, which has been used for decades now in China. According to this method, Shun Chan is the movement in which the little finger leads the energy moving towards the center of the palm, just like this. Well, Ni Chan is the movement in which the thumb leads the energy moving toward the center of the palm, just like this. Bear in mind that both hands and the feet need to have a simultaneous Shun Chan and Ni Chan, and in this video, I will use hand movements to explain the term. Now that you have understood the difference between Shun Chan and Ni Chan, let's talk about the second criterion, expanding or contracting movements. This criterion is rather simple since it's obvious to everyone that expanding movement such as punching involves the release of energy towards the opponent, while contracting movement such as pulling and leading involve moving inward in order to lead the opponent toward yourself. So, when we combine these two criteria together, we get four combinations of movements. They are expanding Shun Chan, expanding Ni Chan, contracting Shun Chan, and contracting Ni Chan. So, if we use Chen Zhao Kui's method, we can organize all of the circulating energy into these four types of circulating movements. Now, let me briefly explain them one by one. First, expanding Shun Chan. Hands move outward with Shun Chan, like this. Second, expanding Ni Chan. Hands move outward with Ni Chan, just like this. Third, contracting Shun Chan. Hand move inward with Shun Chan, just like this. And fourth, contracting Ni Chan. Hand move inward with Ni Chan, just like this. Bear in mind, movement of the energy in this context also includes aspects like intention, variation of the strength, expected martial effect, breathing pattern, and so on. Going forward, you should try to use the method to analyze each Tai Chi movement with respect to circulating energy, since it is a much clearer approach. Topic 4. The practice of circulating. Since circulating is the fundamental practice of Tai Chi, certain principles should be followed in order to achieve the ideal result. Let's look at some important aspects of circulating practice. Tai Chi practice emphasizes Dan Tian, so you should never ignore the function of Dan Tian in your circulating practice. According to Chen Xin, the mind governs the body, and the lower Dan Tian area is the source of internal energy or the area that generates martial power. Any martial movement being the carrier of martial energy should start from the lower Dantian area and then extend to the desired place, such as hands and feet. Following the extending movement, energy will return to the lower Dantian after execution of inward movement. So, there is the cycle of energy flow between Dan Tian and the limbs, or integration between physical movement and energy flow, which should be emphasized by all Tai Chi practitioners. In other words, Tai Chi practice involves practicing different cycles, and all of the cycles should eventually connect to the Dan Tian area. This is the very important guiding principle in circulating energy practice. Again, mental focus and martial intention are key factors in circulating energy practice. You may not want to add martial intention into your practice since you practice Tai Chi only for health. Regardless, mental focus is critical in circulating energy practice. Furthermore, specific movement requires specific mental focus. Visualizing the energy flow when working on physical movements will accelerate your progress in practice. Any Tai Chi practice lacking in mental focus cannot be considered Tai Chi practice. I'd like to emphasize the importance of Fa Jin in Chen style Tai Chi training. Many people are under the impression that Fa Jin is against circulating energy. That is a misperception. I will clarify it in the following section. So, Tai Chi practitioners just cannot avoid Fa Jin in their circulating energy training if they want to achieve any martial benefits. One of the functions of circulating energy is to smoothen the energy channels of the body and make energy flow smoothly in and out of the body so that it can be released whenever necessary for martial applications, which is nothing but Fa Jin. Unless you want to practice Tai Chi only for health, Fa Jin in circulating motion is the must-have. Also, circulating energy practice has a close relationship with breathing. In general, the speed of breathing follows the speed of physical movement. In the context of coordination between breath and movement, normally an inhalation will accompany an inward movement, while an exhalation will accompany an outward movement. However, in Fa Jin movement, there will always be an exhalation, never inhalation. It is an important factor to have effective Fa Jin in terms of coordination between breathing and circulating movements in different directions. Since circulating energy is the foundation of all Tai Chi movements, you should not only practice the Tai Chi routine by focusing on the circulating energy in each movement, but more importantly, you should also practice single movements in order to practice specific circulating energies. I will introduce one such single movement in the demonstration section. Topic 5. Misperceptions of circulating. Clarification of misperceptions can help us comprehensively understand a topic, and circulating is no exception. Let me share some of the most common misperceptions of circulating energy practice. They are, first, circulating only involves the arms and hands. Second, circulating does not involve Fa Jin. Third, circulating is practiced only in Chen style Tai Chi and not other styles of Tai Chi. Fourth, circulating is only used in Tai Chi practice. There are others wrong. Let me explain them one by one. First, circulating only involves the arms and hands. This is not a mere mistake, but a crime in Tai Chi practice. Bear in mind, Tai Chi practice is never limited to arm and hand movements, but instead engage the entire body. In other words, when one body part moves, so the others in coordination. Any Tai Chi movement should not be done in isolation. Of course, some parts of the body move more than the others, making their movements more pronounced, while movements of the other parts are more subtle and often go undernoticed by the untrained eye. An advanced practitioner should be able to integrate all of the movements as one in order to achieve an optimal martial effect. Second, circulating does not involve Fa Jin. Another very common misunderstanding of Tai Chi and Fa Jin. As I have mentioned in a prior section, Fa Jin is an important practice of Tai Chi. There's no conflict between Fa Jin and circulating energy. On the contrary, practicing circulating energy can amplify your Fa Jin. If you have a hard time with Fa Jin, I recommend adding circulating to your practice. So, Fa Jin and circulating are not mutually exclusive, but instead, mutually strengthening aspects. Third, circulating is a practice only in Chen style Tai Chi and not the other styles of Tai Chi. You have to know that even though other styles of Tai Chi do not use the term Chan Si Jin, circulating energy does exist in all of the Tai Chi styles. Whether style of Tai Chi uses the term or not does not change the nature of the practice. For example, in Yang style, people use Chou Si Jin or silk pulling energy to describe the characteristics of that style's movements. Actually, Chou Si Jin emphasizes the subtle continuity of Yang style practice at the macro level, while Chan Si Jin in Yang style Tai Chi is at its micro level, which is part of Yang style as well. So, even though other traditional Tai Chi styles may neither use the term circulating energy nor have obvious circulating movements in their routine, circulating energy is present in those Tai Chi styles all the time. Fourth, circulating is only used in Tai Chi practice. This is another misunderstanding. Again, using different terms to describe the same practice is a common phenomenon in martial art practice, and circulating energy is one such example. Both Xing Yi and Ba Gua use circulating energy, though mentioned in different terms. For example, in Xing Yi, we call it Qi Zuan Luo Fan. Qi means to move upward. Zuan means drilling. Luo means moving downward. Fan means turning. So, the words Zuan and Fan, or drilling and turning, share the same practice as circulating energy. In Ba Gua, we use the term Zhuan Zhang Ru Ning Sheng, or turning your hands like twisting ropes. So, the rope twisting motion is synonymous with circulating energy. Therefore, circulating energy is a common concept in all three internal styles, though present with different names and with different practices. Those were just four of the many misconceptions regarding circulating energy. I will introduce more in the future. Topic 6, demonstration. Today, I'd like to demonstrate a circulating exercise, which is the double hand circulating movement. In this exercise, one hand works on Shun Chan, while the other hand works on Ni Chan. It is the arm movement of the Tai Chi from a waving hand. To practice this exercise, you keep a stable Tai Chi stance, and then sink down the body, relax the hip area. Then look at the direction where palms come. Okay. Then shift the weight. Then shift the weight. Then shift the weight. Be careful this movement in front of the shoulder. Then the knees make small circular movement and the body shift the weight with the backward and the downward arc. Then you can make the movement slower. Topic 7, takeaways. First, Chen Xin, an outstanding Tai Chi practitioner, wrote the book at the tradition of Chen style Tai Chi, his book is the must read for any serious Tai Chi practitioners looking to advance their understanding of Tai Chi concepts. Second, Chen Xin created the term circulating energy based on Chen Wangting's Tai Chi poem. Circulating energy is the spiral-like movement that is considered the most important fundamental practice of Chen style Tai Chi. Third, Chen Xin and Chen Zhaokui used a different method in the classification of circulating energy. Fourth, in the practice of the circulating, the mind governs the body, and the lower Dantian area is the source of internal energy or the area that generates martial power. Circulating energy practice should integrate mental focus, breathing pattern, physical movement, martial intention, and so on. Fifth, misperceptions of circulating. First, circulating only involves the arm and the hands. Second, circulating does not involve Fa Jin. Third, circulating is practiced only in Chen style Tai Chi and not other styles of Tai Chi. Fourth, circulating is only used in Tai Chi practice. Bear in mind, all these are misperceptions and should be avoided. Remember to check out the demonstration section to get the concrete idea of how to practice circulating in Tai Chi. And a quick reminder to send me your questions for next week's Q&A. That brings us to the end of today's video. Thanks for watching. See you next time and enjoy your circulating practice.